guys, Aloy Andrews here, and today we will see a comparison on edit poly performance between Max, Maya, Houdini, and Blender. This is the spoiler of what you will see. It's the four different softwares and the different speeds at the end of the video and seeing how they behave. Just because I know that a lot of people doesn't watch until the end, so here you have it. And now we will go into more detail into each one. Let's start with 3ds Max. Entering into edit poly is totally immediate, there is no lag, and selection with the drag selection as well, there is totally no lag, it's simply immediate. If you switch to edge takes maybe half a second to select something, it's a little slower, and faces it's again totally immediate, and switching between modes is totally fast. In previous versions of 3ds Max, switching between modes in edit poly was taking some time with high-res models like this one, but on 2020.2 this has been totally fixed, as you can see. Let's check with lasso tool. The lasso tool as well, it's totally immediate, there is no lag at all when selecting with lasso tool. And with brush tool, if you select the brush, you will see that if you go slow it's totally fine, as soon as you go fast it skips some frames. Now in Maya, it takes a second to enter into edit poly, and selecting vertex with the drag, there is a quite significant delay. I would say it's a second between the selection and the selection is finally available. Edge mode, again, there is quite a delay, and face mode, the same delay with vertex. Vertex, edge and face, here you don't see the face selection, but it's done already. Switching between modes, there is quite a delay. I would say it's around 2 seconds of delay between edit poly modes. Now the problem is with lasso tool in Maya. I check a lot of stuff online to see if people found the same problems. I am with the latest Maya, Maya 2019.2, I think it is. I downloaded it just today, 11th of November, so the latest available. I will not wait for that, but it took literally 4.5 minutes for the lasso tool to be done. I will speed up the video. I have no idea what's going on. I try multiple stuff, I restart the machine, it's always the same. It gets irresponsible for 3 to 4 minutes with the lasso tool. With low-res objects it works well, but with this high-res object it's totally impossible to do anything. With the brush tool, you can see there is a significant lag, you need to go really slow. The difference with 3ds Max is that if you go faster, instead of skipping frames, it does a linear interpolation, it looks straight, so it's not great, but the lag is significantly bigger. Houdini Edit Poly enters in Edit Poly really fast, and also the selection with Vertex mode is really fast when we do drag and drop. There is no difference here with 3ds Max at all. When we switch to Edge mode, on Edge mode we can see clearly that it's way slower and there is a considerable delay between selections. You can see that it's trying to make a preview while you are dragging and it's lagging a little. And when we go into Primitive mode, that is the same as Face mode in 3ds Max or Maya, this again it's fast, there is no delay at all, really fast. Switching between modes as well, Houdini is really fast, there is no lag at all. Lasso tool in Houdini is really fast as well, you will see there is no lag, you have a preview while selecting, it's really on par with 3ds Max in this case. And the brush tool as well is one of the best, it's the fastest one, it's not skipping frames on this case, so in this case it's faster than 3ds Max for the brush tool. In Blender we enter in edit mode selecting tap, and it's the most slow from all the softwares that we see today. It takes like 2-3 seconds, and as well selecting it's slower. In vertex mode, dragging, it takes a second and a half to do the selection, quite slow. Switching in modes, edge mode, it takes as well a while, and also it creates a flash. And edge mode as well, it's slow. I will not say it's slower than vertex because it was really slow before. And going to faces as well, you will see flashing of the interface. And then you can select faces, but with a considerable lag. And switching between modes, it's really slow. The problem I see it's doing is it's trying, instead of keeping different selections for vertex, faces and edges, it's transferring, it's converting the vertex selection into edge selection and the edge selection into face selection. Maybe that's why it's taking more time, but it's really slow. We can see like 3-4 seconds in between. Any other software, by default, you will select all vertex, visible or invisible, with a toggle to be able to only select the visible. In Blender, that's not the case. So if you are in the normal mode, you will never select the back faces. You need to enter into X-ray. Entering into X-ray, then when you do a selection, you select all the vertex, the visible and the not visible. That, well, yeah, it's Blender, I don't know. Lasso tool has no difference in speed between the normal drag tool of the square. It's slow, it's not the fastest, there is 1 second delay, but it's the same, similar to the other options. With brush tool, things are not better. You will see that it takes like a while, and because it's a brush tool, from all the applications it's the slowest. It skips frames, but the lag is really, really big. Let's go into manipulating this vertex. In 3ds Max, we are getting 15 frames per second, whatever we do, moving, rotation, or scaling. Ctrl-Z, it takes less than a second, it's half second to do Ctrl-Z. You can see it's workable, and now Ctrl-Z, it's half second. Going into Maya, as you can see, I am trying to move. I am moving, but it works kind of like 5 frames per minute, something like that. It's impossible to do anything. I try multiple stuff. Yeah, it's simply slow and the lag is horrible. We are not with soft selection right now, we will see this later. It's plain moving vertex around, super slow with 2 million polys in Maya. Now in Houdini, if we move, we can see that we move things at 2.2 frames per second, faster than Maya. Still, it's around 10 times slower than 3ds Max, but it's kind of workable. We can see that when we do Ctrl-Z as well, is more or less the same speed as 3ds Max, a little slower, but I will say that around the same. And let's go for Blender. I move this, and you will see that after 20-30 seconds, it will move. It's really, really slow. It's painfully slow. It creates flashes on the interface, and you can see that now it moves, but not where I was supposed to. I was dragging it to the left down corner and it went up. I am trying to go to this point. It takes 15 seconds, it's totally unworkable. And another point that I want to do in Blender is Ctrl-Z. I will do Ctrl-Z right now, and you will see it takes 5 to 10 seconds to do the Ctrl-Z. I know that it's something that they know. It took, yeah, literally 6-7 seconds. In Edit Poly, one of the most intensive tasks is using soft selection to do your transforms with gradient. And in 3ds Max, you can see that it's quite fast if you go to low values. If you go to high values, like I will do now, it takes a couple of seconds, but then the cool thing that does 3ds Max is that keep this in memory. So now when we drag and drop, we can do it live. And it's the only software of all what we will see that does that. As you can see now, it's super fast. The first time it takes some time. Here, when we need to deal with these things, we want to use connectivity. We have edge distance in 3ds Max. As well, if we go to a high number, I will go now to 500, that maybe it's too much, it will take some time. It needs to reevaluate all the connection vertex, and maybe this is it's the slowest than Maya and Houdini, we will see later. But again, when this is done, then the soft selection is fast again and interactive in real time, and you can go up and down adjusting it in real time. Using soft selection with transform mode in 3ds Max is as fast as not using soft selection. We get almost 15 frames per second. It's totally workable, it feels really smooth, and you can move or rotate. You can see with rotation as well. Yeah, there is no problem at all manipulating this type of geometry. Maya soft selection by default has a surface that will be kind of like similar to 3ds Max edge distance. If we switch to volume, that will be the similar without having edge distance. You can see that it's quite fast. It takes 1 or 2 seconds to compile the information of the softness and the distance. But the difference with 3ds Max is that if you lower this value and then you go higher, it needs to recompute all the time. So in any case, you will be able to drag and drop live. It's all the time recomputing and not keeping in memory all these soft selections distance. Now, trying to transform this geometry in Maya with soft selection, I will say that it's really inconsistent. I select this, it takes 2-3 seconds. Now I am moving, and more or less, well, it's not fast, it's 1.3 frames per second, like 10-12 times slower than 3ds Max, but not so bad. Now, I try to do it again, I do again a selection, takes some seconds. Now I will start dragging just right now, and until it react, it takes kind of like 6, 7, 8 seconds until starts to move. And I saw that before recording that I play a lot with all the softwares, and I saw that multiple times. It's sometimes more or less expect as you will. It's kind of fast reacting. Other times it takes a lot of time. I have no idea. I have all the latest drivers. I have the latest Maya. If someone knows it, I am not an expert in Maya. But please let me know below if there is something that can improve these behaviors. And let's go to Houdini. Houdini by default is using Surface, has different types of modes for soft selection. As well, if you can see that if you increase and you decrease, doesn't keep in memory the soft selection, so every time needs to recompute. I will say that the first time it's doing it, it's a little faster than 3ds Max, but then when you go lower and higher, it needs to recompute, so you can never scroll in real time to see the soft selection happening. I have some confusion with radio, because some people, if you know, please let me know in the comments. Radio, on my mind, will be the same as not using edge detection or not using continuity for edges. Should be faster, it's basically a radio. And when while transforming in Houdini with radio, it's super slow. I tried multiple times, radio, it's super slow. Looks like it's recalculating every time that you're doing the transform, the distance, and makes going to, well, as you can see, I try to rotate, it's go to 3 frames per minute. It's taking 20 seconds per frame, it's ridiculous. But if I switch to Surface, that in my mind will be slower, but Surface is way faster. So when using Surface, will be like using in 3ds Max kind of the edge continuity. And you can see that here it's 1.9 frames per second, still 10 times slower than 3ds Max, but at least you can interact with it. Blender has not really a soft selection on edit poly. They call it proportional editing object, and it works as well on the object level. As you can see, when you transform anything, you can, with the mouse or the page up, page down, you can control the soft selection. Also works with the scale, and it's super interesting as a concept. It works very well at the transform level. Now, on editing poly, it works as well, but with low res, you can make it work. There is no way to specify a radius previous the transform. You need to do the transform, so move the vertex or scale it or rotate it, and then you can design the radius. Now, as we saw on this high-res object, it's super slow moving without this proportional editing enabled. It's really slow. So trying to adjust the radius while you are moving, that it's already 0.5 frames per second, it's totally impossible. As you can see, I am trying to adjust the radius, it takes 10 seconds to adjust the radius, and as well trying to move around, it's impossible. The big problem that we have is that we don't have a numerical input for this radius. There is no options, it's always by the wheel and while you are performing the transform. So it's really bad for huge res objects. As well, you don't have surface options or edge length. It's a global radius that you have, so it lacks some functionality here. I am very surprised by the poor performance on edit poly, mostly because Blender has one of the best Blender sculpt modes from all the applications. It's, well, we can say it's the best. It's really fast on a sculpt mode. It's simply a joy to use, but on edit poly, the performance is really bad. So I hope that knowing that they can do what Blender sculpt can do, at some point they will improve edit poly performance. And that's all, guys, because it's already 14 minutes. I would like to comment different functionality on edit poly, not only performance, but we will need to keep it for another video. Let me know in the comments what do you think. Give me a like, subscribe to my channel, please. It takes a lot to do these videos. I am surprised for some of these comparisons. I didn't expect Maya behave so bad. I am pretty sure with Lasso tool there is something going on there. If you know, please let me know in the comments. Can be that they fucked up on the last version or there is a problem with drivers or something. Blender, I know that edit poly was kind of bad. I know that the sculpt mode is really good, but I didn't expect to be as bad, to be clear. They need to do a lot of work on edit poly to make it usable. I know that not all people need to work with 2 million polys, but in production, a lot of times we work with this type of assets, we work with scans, or it's quite normal to have 2-4 million assets, and you need to break it, you need to add a noise, you need to add bends, you need to deform and do morph between them. For me, it's totally impossible to use Blender in these types of assets. I am totally sure it works perfectly fine for low res and for mid res. It's great what they can do, and in a sculpt mode it works very well, but on edit poly, sometimes you need edit poly and it's impossible. And yeah, I was surprised with some curiosities with soft selections. I didn't know even in 3ds Max that it was keeping the soft selection when you increase a lot the radius, and then it keeps it in memory, so then you can drag live. It's something I discovered doing this video. And well, yeah, let me know. Thanks a lot to my Patreons to make these videos possible. If you will consider being my Patreon, you will be at the end of my video, you will support me, it's really important, and as well you will have these videos before everyone. So thank you to everyone, guys, and see you soon.